Breaking news!
Breaking news!
Like right now! Seriously, breaking news! Breaking news! Hello collectors and welcome back once again to Brotherhood of the Bat Collectibles, your one stop for all things high-end statue collecting reviews, unboxing, statue chats, live entertainment, and so much more. And like I said at the very beginning, I apologize for all that craziness, by the way. Yes, we have some breaking news, and it actually all came about on Rogues Gallery Live. We had a very special guest, John from Queen Studios, and he revealed a whole bunch of things. He answered a whole bunch of questions and revealed a whole bunch of things that we had no idea that was going to happen. And so I kind of wanted to just quickly break them down in case you missed it, in case you missed all of these announcements, because I thought they were very, very exciting. And so let's check out all the little details that he revealed to us, because again, I'm really excited. Let's do it. All right, guys, so like I said, there's going to be all sorts of new reveals, new details, of course, leading up to Wonderfest this weekend. And of course, we're going to cover it ad nauseum here on the channel, so definitely check it out. We'll have footage, we'll have booth tours from all the major companies, including, of course, Queen Studios, which we're talking about today. But again, I want to thank John for letting us know some of this information that we hadn't known prior to this Rogues Gallery show. I'll put the link up here in case you missed that. But I just kind of wanted, again, to kind of narrow it down and kind of focus our attention on the things that we found out. So this weekend, he said there's going to be some sort of Iron Man battle damage piece that we've never seen before. I'm assuming that they're talking about a bust or a half-scale piece. We're going to have to wait and find out. But I did find that interesting. I asked him because I really like the battle damage Iron Man pieces. And so I thought that was really interesting as well. They're also going to be doing, and I think I maybe spoiled this a little bit because I asked it on the show, but they're doing an Iron Man Mark I half scale. Think about that. Think how massive a Mark I half scale will be. It's going to be incredible. It is such an iconic, unique looking suit from the MCU, and I'm really excited to see exactly what that's going to be like. But again, you can only imagine half scale, guys. It is going to just be insane, and I cannot wait to see it. Supposedly, we're supposed to see that this weekend at Wonderfest. So again, fingers crossed we get to see that. They also announced, for some Superman love here, they announced a Henry Cavill bust. That's right, a life-size bust of Henry Cavill. He did mention that it's dark. And that, to me, means that it's going to be a dark suit Superman. That's very, very exciting. Of course, they've done the Batman bust. They've done the Wonder Woman bust. And now they're going to do a Superman. I did ask if it's going to be similar to the Batman bust. And he said, yes, it's going to be in that same vein, although very dark. So again, that means to me it's going to be the Justice League Snyder Cut black suit, which will look incredible. I can't wait to see. Now, obviously, that's going to be a silicone head, which I'm, again, going to be very excited to see, probably hand-punched hair and all of that stuff. So that is very exciting. Speaking of busts, let's go on to another thing that he said. I don't think he had ever said it before, and we're all kind of like looking at each other like, wow, this is breaking news here. They're going to do a Captain America life-size bust. A Captain America, Chris Hemsworth, life-size bust, and I think it's going to be, I said Chris Hemsworth, I'm sorry, Chris Evans, my bad, that's my bad, Chris Evans. It's going to be incredible. They did say that it's going to be kind of like the Batman, where it's got the lower part of his mouth being silicone, and then he's going to have the helmet, okay? And so it's going to be very awesome, though. I did ask if it's going to incorporate a shield. He did say that that's a separate license to be able to do the props, like the shield and the Thor hammer, Monier, and it's interesting that there's a separate license for that, but a lot of other companies do sell that shield, so imagine this bust with the shield on your wall behind it. Like, how awesome would that be? It's going to be really crazy. And speaking of Captain America, they've also announced they're going to do a half scale Captain America. So how awesome would it be to have that Chris Evans bust right next to the half scale? I mean, come on, that's going to be incredible. I know a lot of Marvel collectors are going to be very, very excited about that. I just can't even imagine what that's going to be like. But anyway, so those two Captain Americas were also announced. Another big announcement for the life-size bust. Now, they already did a Spider-Man bust, a life-size bust from Queen Studios, but now they're going to do a Tom Holland version. I don't know if it's going to be the same pose or if it's going to be something different, but it is the Iron Spider look, with the Tom Holland head. So that to me means it's going to be a fully silicone with the hand punched hair. Really exciting, right? So that's really exciting. Then we also have a new Loki bust. So they had the Loki bust, and I think that was before that they were a licensed company. They were still trying to get on the map. And that sculpt is very, very good. But they're going to do one even better. They're going to do a brand new life-size Loki bust. Maybe this one will be more like the new Loki series. I'm not sure. He did mention that the costume will be a little bit different. But I think the head sculpt is going to blow the original out of the water. I cannot wait to see this. Loki is one of my all-time favorite characters. He's definitely my favorite kind of villain arc, you know, whatever you want to call him. Good guy, bad guy, gray area character. But he's my favorite. I just got done watching the very first Loki episode on Disney Plus. Really exciting. So a new Loki life-size bust coming as well. We did have somebody in the audience ask about Margot Robbie's Harley Quinn. Are they going to do one? They are. They've confirmed that they're going to do one, but we don't know the scale yet. We don't know whether it's going to be a bust or if it's going to be a statue form. I'm actually kind of hoping for a bust. I would love to see what they do to compare it with some of the other companies. Really exciting news. They also announced they're going to do a Batman Who Laughs bust. Again, life-size bust. They're going to be doing a comic book line. They've already announced a Joker bust, which I don't know if any of you guys have seen that, but it's looking really good so far. That same artist apparently is doing the Batman Who Laughs, and that's going to be an incredible life-size bust. It's never been done in a bust form. You know, usually the busts are movie pieces, so this is very exciting to see them do some comic book pieces. Batman Who Laughs, you can only imagine how dark and creepy it's going to be. I think it's going to be phenomenal. They also announced a Doctor Strange bust, that they're going to be doing a Doctor Strange bust. Again, that's going to be very popular, I think, and I just cannot wait to see what that's going to look like. They also announced a partnership with the ECC. Possible North American licenses, possible working relationship with Sideshow. There's a lot of things that they announced, but the big thing was the America stuff, the America license, because right now you can only get their things through Asia and Taiwan and some of those places. So for us in America, this was big breaking news that they are working on a North American license, and they believe that that will happen within the next few months. And so that's very exciting for collectors, especially if they can find a distributor like Sideshow or somebody else here in the United States that's going to reduce costs and get us those products here. And that's very exciting for not only this channel, but also for collectors in this part of the world. It's just going to be easier to get. And I'm just, again, very excited. Again, Queen Studios is a major company on the rise right now. So many reveals that they revealed in that show. So again, thank you so much to John for kind of teasing us a little bit. Again, some of those things are going to be seen at Wonderfest. A lot of them, though, we're going to see in the next year or so. There's also a Wonderfest later on in 2021, so the fall. You know, we're just going to have to wait and see. But again, I just had to bring you this breaking news because I was very excited about it. I want to know in the comments down below, what are you excited about with all of these announcements, with all of these teasers? Is there something that you're really pumped about that you didn't know until you just watched this video? I definitely want to hear your thoughts and opinions. And I cannot thank you guys enough for watching today. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, click that notification bell. Make sure you choose all and check out that join button down below for early access and other perks to our videos. Thank you guys so very much for checking out this breaking news video today. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time right here in the Batcave. Bye, everybody. Hey guys, thank you so very much for watching today. And if you're new here, please hit the subscribe button right here on the screen and check out these two awesome videos. I think you're going to love them. And also please join us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok. I would love to have you join in all the fun. Thank you guys so very much for watching. See you in the Batcave.